This is an introduction to the basics of tuning the Uilleann pipe chanter. The chanter has a few parts that I can show you here. The top comes off. It's a protective tube to cover the reed. The reed is inside here, and this vibrates to make the sound. And then we have the bottom of the chanter that actually plays the tune. The diagram on screen shows the parts of a typical Uilleann pipe chanter reed, and I'll point them out now on a visual of this reed that I have in front of me here. The blades that do the vibrating are up here at the top end. There is some kind of metal band around the lower part of the visible blades. That's called a bridle, and it's used to control the strength of the reed. You see some wrapping here, and it's bound onto a metal tube that is the first part of the bore of the instrument, and this fits into the top of the chanter. If you look closely, you can see that there's a color difference. The outside of the reed here is the bark of the cane. It's a brown, shiny, tan, shiny grass exterior of the grass that the reed's made from. And then in a V-shaped pattern in the center, you can see a bit of wood grain, and that's referred to as the scrape, because the reed is carved from a thick chunk, and it's carved down to a very fine thickness at the end so that it will vibrate. And the reed can be pushed deeper into the chanter or set farther out over a range of roughly half an inch, 10-15 millimeters, depending on the chanter. And this is the first primary means of tuning the chanter. First, I'll push the reed all the way into the chanter as far as it goes. Notice how the tuning dot moves to the right or to a higher pitch when I play the back D, the high note, compared to the low note. This means that as you push the reed into the chanter, the top notes will be raised in pitch even more than the bottom notes. So the whole chanter rises in pitch, but the top notes are affected more. Now I'm going to pull the reed far out, as far out as it'll go, and you should find that the back D, the high D, is flattened even more than the bottom D. There you saw a considerable flattening. When I played the bottom D, the note lit up roughly in the middle of the scale, and when I played the back D, the high D, it moved off to the... So pulling the reed out flattened the entire chanter in pitch, but it flattened the top notes more than it flattened the bottom notes. And it stands to reason, because the notes are very close to the reed, a small move in the reed is a big fraction of this total distance, whereas the same move compared to the whole length of the chanter for the bottom notes is a much greater distance, and so the adjustment is a smaller fraction. So we can tune the entire chanter sharper or flatter, and as we do that, it affects different notes of the scale more. Generally, the highest notes are affected more than the bottom notes. Now, sometimes you may find that a note in the middle of the scale is out of tune compared to most of the rest of it, and we can adjust individual notes with a very simple technique. Here we're going to test the fourth note of the scale, the G, compared to the bottom D. As you can see, when I played the G, the tuning light moved over to the right a little bit, indicating it's a bit higher pitch. And there is a simple remedy for that. This is the hole that makes the G note. The top of the chanter is in that direction, the bottom of the chanter is that way. What we can do to lower the pitch of that G so that it tunes with the bottom D is to cover over the hole and make it smaller using a piece of sticky tape. And we go over the top edge, and that makes the hole smaller, which lowers its pitch, but it also moves the center of the hole a little bit further down since we've covered over the top edge, and that also helps reduce the pitch of the sharp note, lower it, with minimal amount of closing so that we don't lose the loudness of the hole. We'll check it again and see how it tunes. And there we can see the bottom D and the G note are now in tune with each other. If a note is flat instead of sharp, there's really no easy way to fix it except either to push the reed in, sharpen that note, and then tape any other notes flatter so that the other notes are brought into tune with the flat note. So it's a little harder if you have a note that's flat. Now another thing we need to do with the Uilleann chanter is tune both octaves so that they're in the same tuning, because it's very possible with a reed pipe for not only different notes of the scale to be out of tune, but the same note in different octaves. Let's see how the G's are on this reed. When I play the high G, we're seeing the tuning note shift to the left a little bit, indicating that the second octave G is a little flatter than the first octave G. And so the question is, how can we adjust the octaves? And the answer is that it's the amount of air in the inside the reed and the amount of air inside the chanter have to have a certain balance, and that's what brings the octaves into tune. And the rule is, the more airspace there is inside the reed, the sharper the second octave will be compared to the first, or the flatter the first octave will be. The simplest thing we can do to add more airspace inside the reed so that that second octave G is tuning sharper than it is now and comes in tune with the first octave G is to make the reed more open inside. And the way we do that is to move the bridle wire or metal band, whatever it is, up a little bit and open the reed, which will make it stronger and louder, and it also gets more airspace inside as it's more open, and that will tune the octaves. Let's test the reed now that I've opened it up to see if the first octave is a little flatter, the second octave a little sharper, so that they tune. In fact, now I opened it up so much that the second octave is actually tuning sharper. The tuning note moves over to the right when I hit the second octave compared to the first octave. So I was able to not only fix the problem, but make it the reverse. And that shows that you can tune the relative tuning of the two octaves by... Now you may not want to adjust the reed in strength by opening it or closing it, because the strength is your loudness and it's your degree of comfort in playing the instrument. So if you decide that you can't adjust the reed to get your tuning requirements down any more than the reed already is, instead of changing the airspace inside the reed, we can change the airspace inside the chanter. And we do that traditionally by inserting a rush of grass or a piece of wire up inside the bore of the instrument. That displaces some air. It's the same as making the bore a little bit narrower. And we take out some air inside the chanter, and that helps the chanter to meet the reduced air that's inside the reed. So I'll just stick this wire inside. And now let's test our two G's and see if they're in. There you can see almost the identical tuning in the two octaves now that there's a wire inside the bore. So that's one way to make the chanter meet the reed. Now what if the second octave of the chanter is tuning sharp rather than flat? How can we make an adjustment to correct that? The There you can see the second octave G, the higher note, tunes over to the right, so it's sharper. Remember, the balance of the two octaves is that the more air there is in a reed compared to the chanter, the sharper the second octave will be. So we need to have less air. The easiest way to reduce the air volume inside the reed is to move the bridle down towards the binding in this direction, and that closes up the reed and makes it easier to blow. It makes the first octave sharper or the second octave flatter so that it brings them closer together if the second octave is starting out too sharp. So let's test this. And you can see the two G's, high and low, both tune almost identically. The light hardly moves. Now, if we don't want to close the reed up and make it easier to blow, the other way to reduce airspace inside the reed is to insert a thin wire up inside the staple tube. We'll just cut it a little bit shorter than the length of the binding there so that it doesn't block off the top of the staple, the opening inside the reed. And a bit of a curve is all that's needed, and it will just wedge in place, and it'll stay there until you decide to pull it out. So now with the reed left open and stronger, but the wire inside to remove airspace, let's see how the two G's tune. And right now we've got them tuned up again together. Our last exercise in tuning is the hard D sound effect or ornament. It's played on the very bottom D note of the scale, but if you blow extra hard and make a quick A grace note with the bottom finger of the top hand, you'll get a louder version of the D, a little bit more aggressive tone to it, and that can be used for accenting in playing music. And it's often found on these chanters that the hard D is sharp of the regular D, and so you either have to only play one or the other, or else you have to try to find a way to tune the hard D. And it's done there you can see that the meter moves to the right a little bit, showing that it's a sharper pitch. So what we can do is take some kind of obstacle, a matchstick or a strip of plastic, and stick it into the bottom of the chanter. Take that out of there, and you can see it against the brown. And we'll just stick this strip of plastic into the bell, and that should flatten the hard D so that it stays in tune with the bottom D, the regular bottom D, better.